G'day, welcome back to Buildsum, and this is the second video in our series on developing the position of the hips and ridges and the elevations of our roof plans. So just a quick revision on the rules for the process. So remember, all angles formed by external wall plates must be bisected. Only one member is drawn from any one corner. Hips are formed where the plates form an external corner. And valleys are created where an internal corner is formed by two plates. In this case, we've got a valley or an internal corner on this one. Rafters are always set at 90 degrees, and a ridge will always be level and parallel to external wall plates. Okay, so let's go through the process. Now, because this is an L shape, and it's not a simple rectangle or square, we need to start to break it up. So what you do is you find the largest section you can find and break your shape up into two shapes. So large square there, or rectangle, and a smaller square there. So now we can go through the process. So this is now going to be a corner down here. So at all our corners, we need to bisect. So bisected that corner, one on the internal corner as well, one here, one here, one here, where that line comes through, one on that corner, and we've done all those corners. So we've bisected all those points, and wherever one meets that external corner, we've got a hip, and if it meets an internal corner, we end up with a valley. Let's just darken them in, and then get rid of those. Okay, so you can now see we've got hips up here, and we've got a valley coming up here, and a couple of hips over here. So then we can do our ridges, so our ridges being parallel to our wall plates, and at the end of our hips, so our ridges can go in. Okay, so that's our basic shape, but we've got a couple of bits too many in here. So now what we can do, that original line that we put in to break our shape up, we can get rid of it to start with. And now you'll notice that this line here has got nowhere or nothing, no corner on it, so we don't need it. But we do need it from here up, so we're only going to get rid of the bottom half of it. So we actually end up with what we call a broken hip, which comes down to this ridge and valley intersection. Okay, so now we that's the plan view of our L-shaped building. So now we can do our elevations. So remember, with the elevations, we're basically looking from the bottom of the page, and what you see at the bottom of the screen is what you're going to draw up here. And on this one, you're going to look from this side, from the right hand side, looking towards the left hand side of the screen to see what you see up here. So the first thing we'll do is develop all our main points up. Okay, so we've got outside of the plate, this ridge, this one here where the broken hip meets the ridge. Outside of this plate, this hip ridge intersection here, and the outside of the plate there. So again, I'm going to use 30 degrees as my pitch, and we're going to go up. This hip goes up to this point, so I'm going to put that in. Okay, now we don't have a ridge here, we actually come back down to the ridge, so this one's going to come back down till it hits this line. Then we've got our ridge running across to this point, and then we go back down from there down to our baseline there. Okay, so that's basically the shape that you're going to see from the bottom of the screen, which looks a bit like that, so that's good. And then going to the left, we develop our lines across. Now this time we're going to have this hip here coming up there. We're going to then have a little bit of a ridge running across this section, and we're then going to come, well, you'll actually come all the way down, because this hip here runs all the way down there. Okay, and this is actually just a broken hip, so there's going to be another one going, you'll actually see this one going back down there, so you'll see that going down there. Okay, so from this end we see the end of that roof, which is that piece there, and we see this side of this roof, which is that bit there, so that looks good. So there you go, that's how we develop our plan positions of our hips and ridges and valleys and the elevations of that particular shape.